Here at the Infographics Show, we like to investigate life-altering enigmas and crucial issues, such as how you could defeat Jason Voorhees, or the best life hacks for surviving a zombie attack. Yet, while our teams of world-class researchers, historians, philosophers, and undead experts are busy finding new and exciting matters to look into, what we really love is answering questions directly from you, our viewers. Today, we're going to be answering a question by Wayne, who emailed us asking, "What would happen if an asteroid was hurtling toward Earth and we exploded a nuclear device in space to stop it?" Well, we're going to tell you. Join us as we dive into the world of astrophysics, nuclear technology, and simple mechanics to find out. What would happen if we detonated a nuke in space? Let's set the scene. A giant asteroid is speeding toward the Earth. Humanity seems doomed. And since world governments in this scenario are following the direction of Michael Bay, the solution they have come up with to stop a speeding asteroid is detonating a nuclear device in space. As the brave and surprisingly attractive men and women on this mission tearfully start their nuclear bomb planting and detonation journey, they leave the Earth's atmosphere and enter the vacuum of space, where they encounter the enemy asteroid and push the button to blast it into smithereens with their nuke. First of all, what would this blast even look like? Most of us are familiar with the mushroom cloud look of a nuclear blast, but in space this would look entirely different. When a nuclear bomb goes off, it releases a massive amount of radiation. When this radiation comes into contact with air on Earth, it rapidly expands the air, causing the classic blast wave that destroys everything around a nuke. In space with no air around, there would be no blast wave, just a spherical-looking, rapid, soundless explosion of light, heat, and radiation in every direction. The nuclear bomb's radiation in the form of gamma rays and X-rays would affect a much larger radius in space than on Earth, as there's no atmosphere to slow down or disrupt its spread. The good news is there are much fewer humans in space than on Earth that will experience this radiation. The bad news is the radiation would also make its way down to Earth's atmosphere in no time. Side effects of the blast would be seen on the planet almost immediately. Charged particles from the nuclear bomb would interact with Earth's magnetic field, creating ribbons of light that would stick around for hours or even days, depending on the blast's size. Imagine seeing the northern lights, but less Instagram-friendly and more expansive and terrifying. In addition, debris from the blast and the asteroid would rain down into the atmosphere, though most fragments from the bomb itself would burn up and just leave heavy ions behind in the planet's atmosphere. The fragments from the asteroid, depending on its size, are a different story we'll address soon. As a side effect of a nuclear blast in space, most power sources and electronics on Earth under the blast area would be shut off, and there would be disruptions in navigation systems. High-speed, highly charged electrons from the detonation would create a dense but powerful magnetic field known as an electromagnetic pulse, or EMP for short. The EMP would disrupt the flow of electricity for hundreds of miles around the blast. How do we know this for sure? Well, because the US already detonated a nuke in space. That's right. During the Cold War arms race, the US was worried that the Soviets would launch nuclear bombs into space to stop US intercontinental ballistic missiles. Naturally, then the US set up Project Fishbowl so they themselves could test the effects of nuclear explosions in space. One fine morning on July 9, 1962, the US mounted a W-49 thermonuclear warhead on a Thor rocket to conduct a test known as Starfish Prime. It was launched from Johnston Island, 900 miles southwest of Hawaii, past the upper atmosphere. At 9 a.m. GMT time, 11 p.m. in Hawaii, when the missile was on its way back down and had reached 240 miles above sea level, the U.S. detonated the nuke. The explosion released 1.4 megatons of energy. That means that the blast unleashed the energy equivalent of 1.4 million tons of TNT. Because it took place in space, this massive energy burst was strangely soundless. It caused a spherical blast that created an aurora for over 1,000 miles in almost every direction. The effects of the exploding nuke were much larger and emerged much further away than US scientists had ever anticipated. The electromagnetic impulse generated by the blast changed the flow of electricity in Hawaii, 900 miles away, roughly the distance from New York City to Orlando, Florida, while people in Hawaii were getting ready to sleep and suddenly wondered why the northern lights had moved several dozen degrees lower in latitude. They were quickly distracted by blown-out streetlights, radio and telephone outages, and a whole host of other electronic malfunctions. The nuclear bomb's detonation, done close to the altitude of the International Space Station, which orbits at 254 miles above sea level, caused extensive satellite damage as well. The high-speed, high-powered electrons moving through the atmosphere hit at least 6 satellites, causing malfunctions that eventually made them fail. This was in 1962 when Earth had much fewer satellites in orbit. Today, a nuclear blast in space would probably hit hundreds of satellites. As of 2018, there are 4,987 satellites orbiting the Earth, and 1,957 of them are operational. This means a nuclear blast in space would not only send a huge surge of light and radiation charging through the Earth's atmosphere, but also disrupt your Sirius XM Deep Tracks radio station. All things considered, messed up radio stations in a weird hours-long light show would be worth it to save the Earth from a major Homo sapiens-destroying catastrophe, right? Well, it's not that simple. Depending on where the nuclear bomb had to be detonated, for example, if the location happens to be right over a country, the resulting damage could disable a whole country, if not several, in one blow, by disrupting communications and electronic functions. If satellites are hit, this disruption could go on for an extremely long time. But wait, would a nuclear bomb even break apart an asteroid? And more importantly, would breaking it apart even save the Earth in the first place? Most known asteroids in our solar system are found in the asteroid belt, where they orbit the Sun between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter. Scientists believe that the asteroids are the remains of planetesimals, which were early pieces of the solar system. Some asteroids are primitive, unchanged pieces of the original solar system that never formed into larger bodies, while others are the remains of differentiated pieces of the solar system, smashed to bits by Jupiter's strong gravity. While many asteroids mind their own business orbiting within the asteroid belt, some are affected by outside gravitational pulls and flung out, setting into different orbits around the solar system. If an asteroid is big enough to pose a threat to at least part of humanity, then it must be at least 1,312 feet in diameter. 6.2 miles in diameter is the threshold for extinction-class asteroids, which pose a much larger existential threat. Extinction-class is a nice scientific way of saying everything on Earth would be dead if an asteroid that big collided with our planet, except maybe cockroaches and Keith Richards. The asteroid that caused the Chicxulub impact and wiped out 3/4 of plant and animal life on the planet 66 million years ago, including the dinosaurs, was at least 6 miles in diameter, with some scientists theorizing that it was up to 50.3 miles long. The bad news is plenty of asteroids in this extinction class still exist, rocketing all around space. The largest known asteroid, Ceres, is a whopping 294 miles in diameter, or almost 48 times larger than the size needed to end us. The good news is, sizable asteroids rarely collide with the Earth, only once every 160,000 years, according to NASA scientists. Also according to NASA, detonating a nuclear bomb planted at or beneath the surface of a large asteroid, even an asteroid at the bare minimum threshold of 1,312 feet, would just cause the asteroid to break apart into still large pieces rather than obliterated. These asteroid chunks might continue racing toward the Earth and still be big enough to cause significant damage. NASA believes it would be very difficult, if not outright impossible, to determine the way in which a nuke would break an asteroid apart, so there's little hope of controlling the size of the fractured pieces. Factors like size, center of gravity, and material – some asteroids contain carbon, while others are made of iron or stony iron – would affect the way an asteroid would fracture, in most unpredictable ways. However, a nuclear device still could be used to guide asteroids away from the Earth through deflection. In fact, NASA scientists think this would be the best way to use nuclear bombs to avoid colossal damage to humanity and the planet by rogue asteroids. While surface and subsurface explosions would probably just split the asteroid, nuclear bombs that explode near but not on the asteroid, in a process called standoff explosions, would hopefully release enough energy to change the asteroid's course. Thus, the recommended strategy for winning people versus asteroid is a series of standoff nuclear explosions to push the asteroid another way. We might end up with a shattered moon, but that's a risk we'll take. Is there any real chance we'll have to use this strategy soon? Well, scientists think it's unlikely, as the probability of a large asteroid hitting our Earth in the near future is slim. However, the Apophis asteroid, even though it's relatively small at 1,100 feet, is worrying a few governments. It's projected to pass within 19,000 miles of Earth's surface on April 13, 2029. Even though this seems like a massive distance, it's relatively close in space terms. If you make the comparison, the Moon is 238,900 miles away from the Earth. The fact that Apophis is swinging by the Earth on Friday the 13th probably doesn't help ease people's fears. However, most scientists are looking at this event as a data-gathering bonanza, as objects that large rarely make their way toward Earth. Still, the director of the Russian Federal Space Agency, Anatoly Permanov, announced in 2009 that Russia will brainstorm ways of deflecting Apophis if it should come too close. Of course, Apophis isn't the only sizable asteroid making its way around the universe, which is why NASA's Planetary Defense Coordination Office exists, It may sound like a division of Star Trek, but the PDCO is a real agency that uses technology like telescopes and radar to map out the orbits of existing asteroids and detect new ones. Asteroids' movements are compared to known constants like background stars in order to estimate the speed and direction of their orbit. Radar is then used to obtain information about their size and shape of the asteroid. So if the PDO detects an incoming asteroid emergency, would detonating nuclear weapons to stop them still be on the table? Sorry to disappoint fans of explosions, but that's unlikely. If it helps, the existing options sound even more interesting. Lindley Johnson of the PDCO assures us that technology such as kinetic impactors and gravity tractors would be used to divert the asteroid. A kinetic impactor is a special high-speed spacecraft that collides into an asteroid to push it onto another path, while a gravity tractor is a spacecraft that flies alongside an asteroid, using its own gravity to pull the asteroid in another direction. We've got more great videos with answers to your burning questions, so click the video over here for more. Or you can be brave and click this other video over here. Pick one.